Thank you, Madam Chair. Ladies and gentlemen of the committee, it's always so entertaining to be in Lee Seiwan's presence. And I will say, every time I speak to Lee, she always says, you have the greatest name for a lesbian, but last name for a lesbian. Moving on from that, I will say that I did. I wish Lee was here to hear that. She says it to me every time we talk to each other.
I'm sure someone's going to repeat it, so don't worry.
Well, it's a good line. You got to give it to Lee. Anyway, Madam Chair, I was the proud sponsor of this bill last year, and I'm so happy and grateful to you for taking over this year as the prime sponsor. And I know for all the reasons even that you have said in terms of your legal practice in the family court, your knowledge of relationship, not only with the chief judge, but with the associate judges, especially your sister, that you will be in a great place to try to reconcile, if you will, the legislative branch with the judicial branches, and our responsibility to make policy for this state with the judiciary's concerns, if you will. And, you know, as I sat here and was listening to the testimony, I thought, you know, when I first came out to myself, I was in college, and the first thing I said is, wow, I'll never get married and I'll never have children. And, you know, that was sort of how we thought 30 years ago. And when I think of how much has changed in those 30, probably more than 30, 35 years, you know, I mean, technology in and of itself, computers, you know, gone are the days of the VCR and the 8-track, which was our day. And, you know, so much that has changed in terms of medicine, right? I mean, I think we have, like, eradicated smallpox and polio, if I'm not mistaken. And look at, you know, we put in bionic hips and bionic knees and bionic shoulders for people. So much has changed in the area of assisted reproductive technology as well. Yet our laws have absolutely unequivocally failed to keep pace. I mean, I don't know when Rhode Island last changed any laws regarding adoptions or parentage vis-a-vis gay and lesbian people, but it is probably 20, I'll tell Lisa afterwards, 20 or 30 years ago or more. So, you know, ladies and gentlemen of this committee, just as I had said when we were debating on marriage equality, I mean, the time has come. And I do, you know, not only in listening to the testimony, you know, do I think that we have to update our laws. I mean, I think failing to do so is just ripe for, there has to be an equal protection argument here when, again, Attorney Iwan laid out so easily how any male can go in and say that they are the, you know, the parent of a child. I mean, it's just so blatantly unfair and a denial of equal protection of the laws that I, you know, am sure if we don't do something that there has to be an equal protection lawsuit in there. You know, others have said here about the hassles, the expense, and I would add the indignity of two people, two lesbians, two gay people who go through a process of trying to have a child, getting pregnant, having a child, and as we said, that only those two people have planned to raise that child. You know, there, of course, you know, adoption is a beautiful process. You know, Senator Golden has talked about her experience. You know, we've all had friends, family members who have adopted. It's nothing. It's a beautiful process. But for gay and lesbian people who, when two people come together and they go through, you know, so much emotional work, often expense, et cetera, through assisted reproductive technologies, and have a child, to then have to be put through that, I think that there is an indignity and a lack of respect, you know, frankly, for our community that at this time in history, now is the time for us to figure out those challenges that the family court might have and for us to use our power and authority as a legislature to set policy for the state of Rhode Island and right these obvious wrongs that have already been testified to by my colleagues previously.